Graphics Analyzer enables you to evaluate all the OpenGL ES and Vulkan API calls your application makes as it runs on a mobile device. You can explore the scenes in your game frame by frame, draw call by draw call, to identify rendering defects or find opportunities to optimize performance. Graphics Analyzer is part of the Arm Mobile Studio family of performance analysis tools, giving you deep insight into exactly how your content performs. In this video, you will learn how to trace an Android application with Graphics Analyzer and capture extra frame data for a problematic scene. Before you begin, follow the Getting Started instructions on the Arm Developer website to install Mobile Studio and configure your device. When you launch Graphics Analyzer, the first thing you see is the Device Manager. Devices connected through USB are listed here. Select your device and choose the application you want to trace. Then select Trace Activity. Under Trace Config, you can choose which API assets to collect from the device as your application runs. Only enable the asset types you need. The more types you enable, the slower the application will run, the more memory is required, and the generated trace file will be larger. Perform your test scenario in the app on the device until you get to a problem area that you want to analyze in more detail. Press pause and use the step button to get to the frame you want. Select the camera icon to capture the frame buffer output at this frame. We will be able to see the graphics API calls alongside the frame buffer output to evaluate how each draw call impacts the scene. Next, let's capture the overdraw in this scene. Select overdraw mode, then click the camera icon again. If content has a high degree of overdraw, it can perform poorly because of the cumulative cost of shading multiple layers. This can occur even if the layers are simple, especially for devices running at high resolutions and frame rates. Here, we will capture the shader map. This shows your shaders in a different colour, so you can see where they are used in the scene. Lastly, let's capture the fragment count to see how many fragments were drawn by each shader in the scene and how many GPU cycles were spent drawing each shader. When you've finished capturing extra data, disconnect the trace. By default, we see all the graphics API calls in the trace. Select this option to filter the list to just the frames where we have captured extra data. The first frame capture we took shows the frame buffer output in our problem scene. If we expand the frame, we can see the render passes and draw calls within it. Stepping through the draw calls, we can see how the frame is composed. Viewing the geometry alongside the frame buffer output helps us to decide whether the level of detail is appropriate for the object in the scene. Could the complexity of the object be reduced? Does the object contribute much to the scene? If not, can it be removed altogether? Next, let's look at the overdraw capture. To show overdraw, areas of the scene are overlaid with white, where multiple fragments are shaded per output pixel. The whiter the area, the more overdraw is present. Some overdraw is expected where you've used transparency to create an effect, but if you see high levels of overdraw in places where the underlying layers have no visible impact on the scene, you could improve performance by reducing the number of layers or resolving any rendering order defects. Let's look at the shader map capture. Here, we can see which shaders are used in each part of the scene. The shader map helps you to detect problems where incorrect shaders have been assigned. For more detail on shaders, we can look at our fragment count capture. In the Shaders tab, we can see the results of the vertex and fragment counts for each shader. Let's look at fragment shaders. If we sort the table by percent cycles, we can find the most expensive shaders. If a scene has too many fragments to process, or if fragments are too expensive to process efficiently, you may see slow performance. We should try to optimize expensive shaders by reducing their complexity or by reducing the number of fragments they have to process. For more videos in this series and for more information about Arm Mobile Studio, visit the ARM developer website.